We skip to the next presentation. Our next presenter cannot be here with us today, but using all the digital possibilities, he's there digitally. Warm welcome to Dr. Markus Imsen. He's managing director of 52 Technology, is the name of the company. We're happy that you join us in this session. I give the word to you, to your presentation about virtual materials.
Thank you very much for a nice introduction. Thank you for having me here. And I think we can start now with my presentation. I hope it works. Should be soon visible. Yeah. Okay. So directly we jump to the first slide. So we humans are great in envisioning things like aeroplanes, and we are not only great in envisioning these things, but we have also the engineering power to construct, actually build these things and overcome the fundamental laws of physics or use them to then achieve great mobility. And so we as 52 are a company who's providing software tools for engineers that they can create even better tools and engines. Yeah, we are located in Freiburg. We are founded 6 years ago. Now we are almost 30 people, and we are relying on strategic partner, sales partner for the automotive industry. We are working very closely with AVL, which is also distributing our software, which is called Prion Lab. You see here our customer, a logo wall where you can see that we are more than 90% of our customers are coming from the automotive industry, and they are using Prion Lab in various different ways, which I would like to show you in this presentation how what you can do with Prion Lab. Therefore, first of all, we would like to look at a nice example, which should come now on the next slide. Yeah, so here we have this nice car and this nice automatic opening of the trunk, which works very well and is user-friendly in most of the scenarios, but there are some scenarios which it might cause some problems. And so we with Prion Lab are able to simulate different fluids, including snow, where you can test your vehicle and different parts, components of this vehicle in terms of how it interacts with these materials. So here you see a complete simulation done with Prion Lab of the same scenario, where you could in a virtual environment test how the car will interact, or what the consequences will be when you open the trunk, when there is water on top, when there is snow on top, or even mud. All simulations, videos, animations that you see in this presentation are done with Prion Lab completely. Also, the visualization is done in Prion Lab. Here you see a planetary gearbox, which is done, performed by a customer of us without any training. So we focus on very user-friendly software, lean workflow. If you have the CAD data, then you can import these into Prion Lab, and you can set up the scenario in Prion Lab and do the simulation. Coming now to a use case, this how, for example, Schaeffler is using Prion Lab for optimizing the lubrication concept of gearboxes, especially for electric engines, where we have very high rotation speeds. You see here on the right-hand side the task. So we want to increase, or Schaeffler wanted to increase, the oil flow into the upper channels, and these for all driving conditions. So the idea of the engineer was to build this oil deflector, this plastic device, and which should then help to pump or to keep more oil flow in the upper gallery, in the upper channel, such that the cooling component of oil here is also satisfied. But the question is, what is the optimal design? And not only for one driving condition, but under all driving conditions, different speeds and different temperatures. So we come from a very big design space, and if you have this virtual tool like Prion Lab, you can already in the very early development stage test this virtually. And really, these simulations were run overnight so that the customer could simulate the different designs and test the different designs and then choose for the optimal design from the simulation, which was then built and later on was verified in the test bed that the mass flow increased by a factor of 6 for all different conditions. So in one of the previous slides, I've told you that our USP is usability, but it's also efficiency. We are by far faster than traditional methods. Traditional simulation methods are grid-based methods. We are using particles. So we are a spin-off from the University of Freiburg. I have more than 10 years of research done in the field of particle-based methods, and these particle-based methods have some intrinsic advantages. Together with the research of our team and the R&D work been done in the last 6 years, we are now able to do things that were not on are not possible with traditional methods. One other example and use case is water wading. Here, the user is interested about the water level in front of the HVAC system, for example, or the underbody forces, especially important for electric cars, where you have the battery packs on the lower part of the car. In traditional methods, which you see on the left-hand side, the car is stationary and you change the reference frame so that the water is flowing around the car, not the car is driving through the channel, which is the case in real world. With the particle-based method, you can do this. You can really drive the car like in reality through this channel. You have the rotation when it goes down the slope, and you have the rotation of the wheels, and more importantly, you have also the suspension of the car can be modeled, and it really reacts due to the underbody forces, which you see here on the left-hand side, the comparison of the simulation to in the bigger picture and the smaller picture, the real-world video. So. And on the right-hand side, you see the comparisons. Orange is the simulation prediction, and the blue line was the real-world measured data for the deflection of the spring mass. So this matches very well. And there's also master thesis by Volvo, where you can get more details. So reliability, of course, for such a tool is very important, not only for this big volume of water, but also when it comes to low, smaller amounts of water, where we have also microfluidic behavior. Like here's a test bench from IAV, where they tested the capabilities of Prion Lab and other tools with respect to this test bed. And on the left-hand side, you see the simulation results, again, simulated completely and visualized with Prion Lab, can be done by the customer since we provide presets. And on the right-hand side, you see the real-world test bed. So there are also data that we can show or which you can find on our website, as well as for this Renault example, where we show, or the customer has shown, that Prion Lab is capable to predict really microfluidic behavior and can be used to for safety reasons when it comes to oil leakage, where this oil can come into parts of the car or shouldn't come into parts of the car where it causes inflammation. And yeah, the user can just use presets or define the physical properties like surface tension, viscosity, and then he gets the real behavior of what he can do in a real test, but in virtuality and at a much earlier stage in the development. So flagship applications in the automotive industry are sensor soiling for water, oil, snow, or mud, where you can optimize your sensors, your camera positions, especially for autonomous driving cars. We have water wading, we have seen this lubrication optimization, or for gearboxes, and a newer application is e-motor cooling, so we can also simulate the heat transfer. And what is very important here is, so Prion Lab differentiates from other products in its efficiency, in its reliability, and its usability. So it's designed not only for the CFD engineer, but also for the engineer in general. We have many users that are coming from the testbed, have years of experience on the testbed, but and now doing these tests in a virtual environment. And due to the high post-processing capability, so we have really this renderer which can render these photorealistic images, the results can be well communicated to the designer and to the manager for efficient decision making. And we see here room for improvement for the future, for by bringing this also into the cloud, into more faster access from everywhere, and increase the tangibility, the insights by more reality using virtual reality devices or augmented reality. Thank you very much for your attention. This is for my talk. Talk to you later in the panel discussion.
So thank you very much to Markus Imsen from 52 Technology for your interesting presentation.